What's up, YouTube? This is Don Gaming coming at you guys with an NBA 2K22 My Career episode number 18 coming at you guys. We're still a six man, of course. On fire though, so I might be able to get to the starting position. I don't know yet, but we'll see. But first things first, I already told you guys, I know I hate playing the same team, but we're gonna have to in order to get to the Grizzlies game. So let's get it. Get on to the Rockets. We versed the Rockets two games in a row. And then we versed them, well, we versed the Grizzlies after that game.
Welcome to NBA TV and season 2 of NBA 2K22. Build your
empire. Well, my strategy is I'm going to play these two games,
season 2,
and then I'm going to verse the Grizzlies in the same exact video, see how long the video is,
and the theme is play your way to 2K TV. Want to get on 2K TV?
I'm hoping that I could get through old games before this recorded ends. That's what I'm
doing. And the starting lineups have been muted. So just to...
We're going to have to skip all this because I don't care.
It's the NBA on 2K Sports.
You already know. I'm on the bench. I'm the sixth man.
In the NBA for sure, David. Thank you.
There's the starting lineups if you care to look at them. There you go.
They've got favors. Lou Dort out there with Gilgeous Alexander. And it's Roby in at the foreshot. And for Houston.
Reversing the Rockets two games in a row.
The pairing up front, Tice and Wood.
So, our record against the Rockets, we have not lost
any
yet. Here
for Houston.
So, it looks like we're not going to lose at all.
First quarter play, and just over 3.5 minutes in. Pass to MP. Takes the three.
There it goes.
Knocks down the three ball.
And really setting the tone early with their three-point shooting.
That's already 5 made triples in the first quarter. What a start.
Now Nwaba. He is still scoreless so far in this one. Pass to Augustine. Porter looking it over. Another shot. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting for
those here. All right.
That's his even from over here, you can see that one pretty clearly.
No question about it. I mean, a ton of contact. A good call by the official.
Kevin Porter Jr. at the line for two.
That misses, so he splits the free throws.
And that one gives them a +5 rebound advantage, Kevin.
Pretty clear. They're dominating that area. They've come out with a lot more energy and effort so far.
And wow. The call on the shot sends him to the line.
And really, the defense fouling there to prevent the layup, but that's exactly what you need to do.
It is. I mean, no reason to back off and give him the layup. Much better off making him go to the line.
And even both free throws good for MP.
Free throw shooting is about mechanics, confidence, and your mental approach. He's locked in from there most every night.
Yeah.
There's the pass to Nwaba. And the layup falls.
You know, that kind of unselfishness, guys, from Augustine is really infectious, especially when it's coming from your point guard.
4 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. MP outside. Out to the wing. Baisley passes to MP. The Thunder with another miss.
Thunder foul. Number 23.
Why did it foul, bro?
In their last contest, guys, he was unconscious from the foul line.
Splashed one after another. It really was quite a display from the strike. And, guys, that's an increase in his free throw percentage from last year. Maybe not a large one, but it is a little bit higher, so you've got to like that progress.
Aladon passes to Baisley, and here's MP for three. Go that time. And
All right.
It's Lou Dort making things happen for the Oklahoma City Thunder. He comes away with
I got the foul,
and
then I missed the three.
No signs.
He was right up in my grill, so I couldn't really shoot the ball.
And And thanks again for tuning in. If you're just joining us, we played through
one quarter of action so far. I don't see a playoff run
for these guys. And for the Thunder guys, what stands out to you so far?
Just stretching out the floor that first, they had the defense scrambling.
And you know what? That's what happens when you establish your three-point game early.
Bang
it. The defense right up.
All
against
right, don't shoot it again.
David Nwaba out there.
I should have passed it, but I
then there's Kevin Porter. Then there's DJ Augustine.
Should have passed it.
And it's Şengün in at the five. That's the group starting the second quarter for the Rockets. A fadeaway. Keeps it alive. Great positioning on the putback. Wabba's got the first basket of the second quarter for Houston.
Hard work and soft hands, guys. That's what made that play possible.
No simple offensive rebound there. Going for the tip in.
But that's the way to go if you've got good position.
MP's shot is good.
You know, the defense has to be better. I mean, you can't give up that look.
Yeah.
Here is Augustine. No points in the game yet for him. Here's Martin. And it's Beasley with the rebound.
Boy, that's a look. He has to finish, and he knows it. Lone opportunity.
MP deciding where to go with it. Over Martin. The shot's yeah, good from Beasley. Beasley.
Nice.
Beasley's got his first points of the night.
Number 23.
And we're now about a minute and a half into the second quarter. Now here is Augustine.
Go.
He's guarded closer.
Go, Rockets, go.
The putback controls the rebound and puts it back up and in.
Şengün's
got his first 2 points.
Yes.
Now a timeout called by Oklahoma City.
Got ball sitting on the bench now. All right.
And Oklahoma City going with
he'll probably be out on the floor, though. Just like I'm on the bench now. Yep, John Wall's on the court now.
So it's Oklahoma City.
At halftime, we're up by 10 points so far.
And it's been their rugged defense.
Up by 10 points. During the half. Here we go. 7 points, 1 assist, 1 three-pointer made. Ah, okay.
And for those of you just tuning in, thanks for being with us. The second half of this game still to play.
Sitting on the bench. What's up with that, coach?
Now, with some changes. Jack comes in for Derek Favors. And MP subbed in for Dort. Taking a look at the Thunder. They've got MP. And it's Roby in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. A three from MP.
Ah.
The Thunder with another miss. It's trailed by
that's a good look, though.
Here's Tate. And it's thrown down hard with both hands.
You get open, and Wall will find you.
He's got standing around doing freaking nothing. Come on now.
A true leader on and off the floor. Wall is a super charitable guy.
No doubt about it, T.A. I mean, he raised money for rent assistance. He donated N95 masks and meals to hospitals. And that
pass too freaking late,
just
bro.
Just in the last year or so. Very, very outgoing with his generosity.
Oh, great ball movement there.
And here's Gilgeous Alexander. He'll bring it up for the Oklahoma City Thunder. A touch over 2.5 minutes of basketball played here in the third quarter. Right wing. Roby the pass to Gilgeous Alexander. Clock at 4. A 3 from MP. The shot, no good. The Rockets go the other way with it. And it's Houston's ball. They're on an 11-2 run. Now let's go to the sideline and catch up with our Hall of Famer, David Aldridge.
Thank you, Kevin. The Houston Rockets are rebuilding. That's a hard pivot for a team that, until last season, was pursuing titles. The new front office has been candid. It's presented challenges as they look to go young and stack up draft picks. They plan to make constant bets on unproven talent as they build toward the future. Kevin?
All right, David, thank you. Offensive rebound, Wood, and finished off by Wood.
God dang.
Well, anytime you've got a player that can give you extra possessions, that's a great asset, and Wood is a fantastic offensive rebound.
Now a timeout called by Oklahoma City. In addition to going over the game plan and making whatever necessary adjustments have to be made, Greg, this timeout also the time for players to get rehydrated for the first time with some Gatorade. Plenty of basketball still to be played here, and they have to get recharged.
That's a great point. Without proper hydration, a player can completely run out of gas down the stretch of a game, and that's something that none of these guys can afford to have happen. If you're going to battle all the way to the finish, you have got to be hydrated.
And here's MP for three. Nailed from three-point land.
3 points.
MP's got 10.
He drilled one from deep in the first half, doing it again here in the second.
And Augustine kicks to Porter.
And two for six from
back
the
to
three.
Augustine. Here's Şengün. The Thunder pull it in. There's 47 seconds left in the third quarter. Here's Melodon. Nwaba defending. Kokusevski with the bucket.
And not quite as aggressive from outside as they were in the first half. Sticking to the high percentage shots, playing smart with the lead.
Now, here's Nwaba. Covered by MP.
The finish was nice, but.
Seriously?
Coming out of the excellent handles for a front court.
All right,
player.
Fourth quarter in, and we are
big man to be comfortable with the dribble.
11
the
points right now.
I think it's so valuable. Now it's a dozen to a dozen big guys to put it on the ground. I mean, it used to be two out of a dozen
Doors
guys
you
see 6'8" or better that could really handle the ball in my day. But now it's commonplace.
And now,
it's a valuable skill. My dad, my late dad, emphasized that from the time I started playing organized basketball. Make sure you can go with the ball where you want to against pressure. If you can do that, then you'll always add value to your team as a big guy.
The backcourt made up of Wall Houston. And Green. The forwards for them, Tate and Tyson.
Yeah, free throws in.
In at the five.
Love
down
to see
low.
It.
It's the five for Houston right now.
Nice.
And let's quickly check out the scoring breakdown here for the Thunder.
You know, one of the big stories has been the three ball. It's been a key part of their offense throughout the game.
Yeah, but
they
also
be up by 13 by the time that goes in. Yep, it's
just
in.
Kept hitting those shots with consistency.
All right, here we go.
Next trail by 13.
Guarding this man. Guarding this man.
Outside Wall. Here's Tate. Here's Wood. And the rejection by Favors.
Oh, great defense from Favors. Has that sense for when to go for the block.
The Thunder leading by 13. MP outside. Passes it to Giddey. Outside, Gilgeous-Alexander. Oklahoma City needs to get off a shot. And they force the shot clock violation. Great team. And now let's revisit that exceptional Mobile One block.
And guys, they'll think twice about attempting that shot again. That was a big-time rejection.
Houston's gone into a funk from downtown in the fourth. Only one of their 5 three-pointers has found the bottom of the bucket. Here's Tice. An easy 2 points on the layup.
Well, we've seen that movie a few times, haven't we? An easy bucket in the paint.
Well, listless and lifeless at the defensive end. I mean, especially inside. They've really got to pick up that interior defense.
MP passes to Roby. Over Tice. Here's Favors, and Derek Favors with the slam.
Such determination on the glass. Not boxing out Favors is a huge mistake that you cannot afford to make.
Count that one.
Yeah. That's some fancy ball handling right there. Since when does he take guys off the dribble?
In the game, 2 minutes.
Pass to Giddey. He kicks to MP. Here's Roby, defended by Tice. In the corner, it's MP.
Ten.
And again,
bang!
City with the triple.
He's just stretching
Thank
him out.
Thank you very
the defense
much,
has
sir.
Got to do a better job of staying attached
yes, sir.
To him.
Yeah, especially with the score being what it is. I mean, you got to tighten it up on D.
Gilgeous-Alexander against Wall. Here's Roby. That's tipped. Gilgeous Alexander against Wall. It's rebounded by Oklahoma City. Favors got 6 rebounds in the game. Pass to Giddy. Now, here's MP.
Dead.
And the Thunder, another 3.
4-3.
And so just rolling to the finish line now. Rockets. And what has been
nice catch
a very
and shoot,
confident
bro.
Looking performance for Oklahoma City.
When you shoot man. This well from 3-point
that
range,
was a nice catch
really
and shoot.
Hard to stop. The defense didn't
rotate
out
nice work
to stop
way up there, man.
Exactly, Kevin. They were
the player of the game.
And during the long NBA season, each contest important here tonight.
Player of the game goes to Dort. On the
season. And just bulldozing their way through this season series.
Oh, yeah, 20 points.
The victory tonight will make it 3 games to
man,
none for
I
the year
16.
With one left to be played against the Rockets.
Right, here we go.
You know, looking back at all the contributions tonight, it was a really phenomenal all-around
here
game for Lou Dort.
And, you know, there was no stopping him tonight.
Right.
Whenever he got the ball, he was
inside
looking
the paint?
To score. And
nobody
so
helping me out.
One goes.
How about that wonderful floater he has? Showing off an exquisite
oh,
touch.
I'm on the wrong side.
55 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one.
Still on the wrong side.
Man passes to MP. Here's Jerome.
Hey, right here.
MP outside. The pass to Muscala. Driving in.
Time
and that one is good from Jerome.
Yeah.
And the Thunder lead by 17.
And credit the whole team. It was a focused, concerted effort to put this one away.
Yeah, what
yeah.
a time to put the hammer down. Any hope of a comeback? Diminished.
His first personal foul. They ain't gonna win none, so.
At the line,
free throw is
100%. DJ Augustine.
The free throw drops for Augustine.
And, you know, the speedy Augustine is really an excellent teammate and a dependable role player, a veteran presence who can really stroke it.
Okay, here we go. Going for the rebound, boys. Let's get it. This one's going in, probably.
Both free throws good from Augustine. And the Thunder with possession. And so the Thunder now can just hold on to the ball.
Hey, hey, hey.
Here's Mann. So no problem for Oklahoma City as they
lead
get
the game
win.
In total 3
this
points.
This was a very
made.
Strong showing for him, Greg. Not necessarily a runaway win,
that,
but one they'll feel very good about.
Right.
And let's face
let's see how the badges go.
On the road and win in the fashion they did.
Shooting's going to go. Yep. I got my
really
shooting
an outstanding
badge.
Effort all the way around.
Playmaking.
And that'll wrap it up, folks.
Rebound.
For Clark Kellogg, Greg Anthony,
right,
and
cool.
David Aldridge.
So we got
this
our shooting badge finally.
Our terrific 2K sports crew. Thanking you for tuning in.
What am I gonna do for my shooting badge? Probably, I don't know. Pretty sure this is a cutscene. Yep.
I gotta say, MP, I feel like I've been hit by a truck. After everything I've done to get you here and make you feel at home, how is it exactly that you want out this early in your career?
It's business, Mr. Lesser. This is nothing personal.
Nothing personal? Okay, that makes me feel better.
Okay, look, I'm still willing to work with you.
How's that?
I'm just gonna keep things quiet. Still giving my all on court. I'm not looking to bring any problems to you.
There's really no change in your mind here?
It's just not gonna work, Mr. Lesser.
Okay. Your representation will let you know when a resolution has been reached. In the meantime, keep this out of the press.
You have my word.
Hmm. Single double. All right, that was weird. Not gonna lie. Okay, just put shots up. All right. Straight into our next game. Here we go. We're going to be versing the Rockets once again in the same episode. And then after that, we'll be versing the Grizzlies, and then the video will be over.
Our 2K22 cover athlete, Luka Doncic, is known for racking up triple-doubles. Hey. So can you do the same?
I might.
Play with Luka on your team and pull off a triple-double before the end of the season. Then share video.
But like I told the coach, I know that I'll be leaving the team early this season. It's just, you know, dealing with this team, it's been not very good for me at all. I'm telling you all that right now. Yeah, I just don't care for this team whatsoever.
Hi everybody, time to get
I
into
really
it.
Don't care
hey,
for this
Alec.
Team at all.
VA
I really
Wood
don't.
Went undrafted.
I mean, thanks, I play my heart out every time.
Facing off here. Grant, what
but
some of your fiercest
coach doesn't appreciate that
level.
At all,
you know,
until the last
Detroit,
second when
had to be
I won
the Hawks,
team.
And I think probably the Bulls.
I'm here to win. And, you know, when we verse the team, we always feel like we got to shoot it. We got to do this. We got to win it.
Adding the backcourt.
Over half this team in this league is bad, and this team is totally one of the worst teams I've played with, and we're gonna lose against them in this game.
And just under 2.5 minutes elapsed here in the first. To the middle, here's MP. Oh, and makes it with the kiss.
Pounding it inside early and often, setting a physical tone.
Here's Wall. We saw him with 11 points in his last game.
Yeah, it was bursting us.
Shot clock at 5.
2 minutes remaining in the first. 2 minutes.
That one's wide left.
So far, rebounding has been a focal point for them.
Here's Deck, and the rebound goes to the Rockets. Last time they met was in Houston.
They had a tough time beyond the arc. A lot of their possessions ended in missed threes.
They kept chucking from distance, and ultimately it was their undoing. Disappointing result.
And that replay courtesy of the AT&T 5G Slam Cam. And Gilgeous Alexander missing. Houston has gone 2-5.
Why are we doing bad at home?
Growing up ball playing, running back, wide receiver, safety. Right, but just like his idol AI, he gave up the gridiron for the heart.
Pass to Dort. Back to Gilgeous Alexander. MP outside. The three ball. And it's Martin with the rebound. And of course, both AI and Wall were drafted number one overall.
Both are fast, physical, ruthless, and they have the ability to carry a team.
Here's Wood. And count the basket. He was fouled, and he's going to the line for one more. So Oklahoma City going with almost an entire new group here. Baisley, he's checked in for Roby. Pokuševski comes in for Deck. Jerome's checked in for Dort, and Maladon subbed in for Gilgeous Alexander.
We saw Christian Wood break out during the 2019-2020
seriously
season. 57% from the floor, earning himself a monster free agent contract.
You serious? Breaking serious, bro.
Here's Augustine. Pass to Wood. 34 seconds left in the first quarter. That won't fall. He's just 2-5 in this one. Jerome, that's good.
Defensively, you have to stay connected to him on the perimeter.
Houston in the lead.
Of course, now you freaking shoot.
Here's Porter. Now here's Wood. Outside Nwaba from outside the arc. Houston gets it back. Pass to Porter.
On the wing, Nwaba. Over MP. Misses off the right iron. Well, we've seen some great shots in the first quarter. No shortage of offense. Rockets ahead, up by 9.
Oh, and lose by 9, like they said. Of course.
And if you're just tuning in, we've got a wide margin on the scoreboard.
I mean, this team is just
plenty of time left for a comeback.
Like, you can't even freaking play with
them. Break down the game we've seen from the Rockets, guys.
But simple. When you can dominate the boards at both ends, you can control the second chance touches.
They've been quicker to the ball, showing great anticipation and terrific hustle.
So on the floor for Houston, DJ Augustine is out there with Kevin Porter. Then it's Green, then it's Daniel Tice, and it's Şengün in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. Outside Porter. Goes up and lays it in, nice and easy.
Hey, they're just getting pushed around inside.
Oklahoma City trailing. Pass to Jerome. Back to Maladon. Over Augustine, again, Oklahoma City.
Some sick ball skills displayed right there. And he's not the guy you expect to pull that off.
And here's Porter. No luck on that one. And Oklahoma City will go the other way with it this game, following their win against the Rockets.
And it wasn't just their starters putting in work. Their backups were real spark plugs on offense.
In that kind of environment, every point matters. The bench was a huge reason why they won that one.
And their shots are dropping with more consistency now.
Here he goes. They shoot again. And it's good on the layup. Porter's got 4 points in the quarter.
Straight up effort gets him those points. That's what it's all about on the offensive glass.
Pass to Baisley. Here's MP. From behind the arc. That one doesn't drop. The Rockets have gone 2 of 4 here in the second quarter. Outside Augustine. Back to Porter. Now Tice. Clock at 6. On the wing, Green. Knocks it down from distance. And now it's a 9-point Rocket lead.
His offensive skill set is off the charts. He has more than a few ways to punish you.
Now a timeout called by Oklahoma City. Mel Grant's a first-time head coach is coming in this season. Can that be tricky, making that transition one seat over to the head job?
On the bench.
So it's John Wall making highlights for Houston, hunting for opportunities, leading to 9 points in the quarter.
Well, we're losing this game.
And with a big gap on the scoreboard, the second half begins with very different goals for these teams. He's checked in for Wall. A little over a minute gone here in the second half. We've got Isaiah Roby. Ty Jerome is out there with Shai Gilgeous-Alexander. Then it's MP, and it's Baisley in at the 4. That's the lineup out there for the Thunder.
And one move ahead of the defense. A solid pick.
And then the monster dunk to complete the play. Well done.
Oh, come on, guys. Someone has to rotate over. Defensively, that's just poor communication.
Now here's Augustine. Gilgeous-Alexander defending. And Augustine.
I can't do your all's defense, bro.
Get it inside like this. You're going to get a high percentage shot almost every time.
Gilgeous-Alexander finds MP. Pass to Roby. MP outside. Here's Baisley. Tice defending. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Let's it fly.
No good off the back of the rim.
They have a decent advantage in regards to rebounding. And you get some traditional big man stuff from Wood. But you look at his handles, going one-on-one outside the painted area, most centers can't do all the things that he can do.
Here's Gilgeous Alexander. Excellent D there from Tate. For Houston, they've got just 2 of 6 in the second half. Outside Augustine. Back to Green. Fires for three. Knocks down the long J. And it's a 12-point Houston lead. And Wood's shown great versatility on offense. But the same skill set applies on the defensive end as well.
I mean, he can switch. He slides on the perimeter to protect the rim. His skill set is exactly what scouts are looking for now at the center position.
From deep, MP. Again, no good by Oklahoma City. Houston has gone 6 of 14 from the perimeter tonight. Outside Tate. Pass to Wood. Inside, Tice. Perfect pass to set up the lay-in. Tice has got 7 points.
Look at Wood finding ways to contribute. Sees an open man, drops it.
Here's Baisley. Tice defending. Here's MP. No good, and they can't put it into the drought.
Everything right except the finish. Have to keep focus all the way through the play.
Green, the pass to Wood. And he makes it on the layup. He's got 14.
They're finding ways to get the ball into the paint. 5 consecutive buckets.
Now a timeout called by Oklahoma City.
B.A., one thing Wood really knows how to do is 7'2", man. He goes all out every play. Minutes, he'll average double digits.
A different look for Oklahoma City. Favors checked in for Roby. Deck comes in for Baisley. And Maladon subbed in for Gilgeous Alexander. Here's Maladon. Uses the glass on the layup.
He's the one trying to keep them in this game. A tremendous individual effort.
And here's Porter. Pass to Şengün. The Thunder pull it in. Favors has got 8 rebounds in the game. Oklahoma City has gone 0 for 2 from outside here in the third. Here's Maladon. He's guarded by Porter. MP against Nwaba. Here's Favors. Here's Maladon. Up and over Porter. Maladon, no good.
Clean look from mid-range. Coach will probably want to run that play again.
I wouldn't want to be the guy who has to keep him off the boards. He is a beast on the offensive boards.
Now here's Green. He has 6. Fires from 14. He can't get it to go. And so it's Houston going into the break up 12. They've been in total control in this game, and they hope it continues. Back to the game after this break.
Okay. Down by 12 again.
And with the fourth quarter upon.
I'm probably sitting on the bench for the rest of this quarter, I'm guessing.
Rocket substitution.
Roby, he's checked in for Deck. MP comes in for Dort. And Shai Gilgeous-Alexander is subbed in for Maladon. Tate's checked in for the Rockets. Green comes in for Porter Jr. So the Houston 5 right now. Green and Tate on the perimeter. Then there's Kenyon Martin. Then there's John Wall. And it's Şengün in at the 5.
This is a fellow who can fill it up.
He's just going to hog the ball.
It throws the opponent's defensive plan into disarray.
Throws it up high. And stolen by Favors. MP outside. Pass to Roby. And it's blocked by Martin. Now Wall.
To be fair, that was his choice to shoot.
Here's Şengün. Outside. Green. Now here's Wall.
Now I'm saying.
Tries it from the top of the key. Can't get it to drop. Oklahoma City has gone 2 of 6 so far in the fourth.
Pass to Roby. Here's Giddey. Three-pointer, no good. And it's Houston's ball. At one point, they led by 16. Outside, Green. And the layup is good off the glass. And the Rockets lead by 11.
They really came in with the right mindset today. I can guarantee you their flight home will be filled with some smiles.
Yeah, there's no doubt as to who was the better team. I mean, they proved it this week.
Coaches love to see ball movement, especially when it gets you that kind of look.
They can simply hold on to the ball
here.
No question, B.A. They deserve the win.
I guess it's time to move on to the Grizzlies game. Which ain't going to be pretty. I'll tell you that much right now. It ain't going to be pretty, but... Game over.
And so the Rockets take the win. Boy, nice win on the road. By the time this one was winding down, this building was stone cold silent.
We finally lose against
the
Rockets.
That's exactly what you got to do. You have to try to take the crowd out of it.
And that'll do it, folks. For Chris Webber, Grant Hill, and Ali LaForce, I'm Brian
now,
Anderson. Thanking
it is
you
time
for watching tonight's game on 2K Sports.
Giant
so long,
look
everybody.
To. It ain't going to be a game that I'm not going to be looking forward to, that's for sure. I'm telling you that right now. It's going to be a pain in the butt game. And I'm pretty sure the coach, well, never mind. I thought there was going to be a cutscene again about the coach talking to me and all that, but we're moving on straight to the Grizzlies. I'm just going to pray to God that
Levels
we're going to win this game.
And my career are back, but with
I don't know.
New
we might not.
One, in honor of
I don't
breast
know.
Cancer Awareness Month, pick up a free pink t-shirt.
I think
and the clothing rewards don't
skeleton.
Stop there. Pick up an NBA
65th it's a skeleton
anniversary t-shirt at level 6. Okay. A season 2 t-shirt and medallion at level 10. And
I never
a
knew that, but it is now.
At level 37. The accessories are also in full force this season with a built.
Yeah, now we're playing against the Grizzlies.
Up next,
this game's going to be a tough one. I guarantee
Grizzlies.
You. It's going to be
for Oklahoma City.
But anything can happen with one against
on 2K
Sports. A Miami
team. Is coming up.
We won against that game.
Thank you very much.
So,
I can see why, D.A., and I think he's well on his way.
It ain't going to be nothing compared to this
game. And tonight, Greg,
I'll tell you
two
that
teams
right now.
With a lot of history that know each other very, very well.
And sometimes familiarity breeds contempt. And that goes for the
Here
players,
we go.
Coaches, and fans.
Time to burst
so here's
Memphis
Oklahoma
Grizzlies.
City's starting group.
It's
We've
official.
Got Shai Gilgeous-Alexander.
And I'm just going to skip it.
All right,
now it's going to be a rough one.
Changes.
Yes, it is.
Tillman,
it's a rough.
He's checked in for
this
Steven
is
Adams.
Rough.
Anderson comes in for
oh,
Brooks.
My God.
And it's Bane in for De'Anthony Melton. MP against Anderson. Here's Tillman. A chance there to push it to double digits, but it's off the mark. Outside, Gilgeous-Alexander.
2 minutes remaining.
Jack passes to Gilgeous-Alexander. MP outside. Five on the clock. But three. Rebounded.
Oh, that went in and out. Are you serious?
Out of those loose balls and rebounds here to start.
And after suffering that knee injury in the bubble back in 2020, Jackson worked his way back steep.
That's always one of the toughest parts of the game, dealing with serious injury when you're young. They're hoping he can remain healthy because he's a
foundational How am I supposed to guard everything, game?
And what a way to start this game, dominating at both ends of the floor.
They came in prepared, focused, and really jumped on the other team early.
And first
like,
time
seriously.
Of the game called for Oklahoma City.
This is
Tough
stupid.
Loss coming against the Rockets in the last game they played.
I'll tell you, they played hard, they drew fouls, but they could not convert at the line.
You know what happens, you start to miss a few, you develop a lack of confidence, and suddenly it becomes contagious.
And Memphis making a change here. Clark's checked in. The Thunder also changing it up. Jerome, he's checked in for George. And Maladon subbed in for Gilgeous-Alexander. Pass to MP from outside the arc. It's good from long range.
And he's not going to miss that sort of an opportunity from deep.
And here's Anderson. He's coming off a 16-point game against Toronto. Comes up empty down low.
I'll tell you what, I think he thought that was going in. I sure did.
Anderson against MP. Baisley passes to Melodon. Can't cash in from close range. Here are the Grizzlies with the ball. They're on a 13-5 run.
The question is, do you leave him in? Obviously, you don't want him to pick up a third foul this early.
The Thunder shooting their first free throws tonight. The first trip to the stripe in this one.
Tao Melo taking two shots.
First free throw is good. And the Grizzlies with some changes. Hernan Gomez comes in for Kyle Anderson. And Brooks subbed in for Morant. And Oklahoma City also making a switch. Okoshevsky's checked in. We've got 28 seconds left to play in the first quarter. Brooks feeling it out a bit. And there's the pass to Tillman. And it's Melodon with the rebound. MP left side. And he got that one up in time, but doesn't go in. And so it's Memphis, with their lead standing at 6 points here at the end of the quarter. Their defense has been active.
Yeah, not bad. We came back for a little bit.
And hope you've enjoyed the broadcast so far, halfway through the first half in this one. And taking a look at the Grizzlies' performance here, guys, what have they been doing or not doing?
Stingy on the defensive end in that first quarter. They were just getting up into people.
Yeah, they were very physical and very aggressive. They've just been the better team so far.
They've got Clark. They still got the rebound, though.
Spain in at the one spot. That's the group for Memphis to kick off the second quarter.
When you watch Dylan Brooks play,
next one's going
to
be in.
He's got some sandpaper to his game, not shy about trading elbows.
He's a good free throw shooter.
I love those guys. You need these guys to win in this league. Willing to take the defensive challenge and put their bodies on the line to get stops.
Here's Baisley. Drops in the tray.
Nice.
Baisley's got himself going with the triple, his first basket of the game.
This is the shot you want to get him. An open look from range.
He needed that bad.
Melton feeling it out a bit. Pass to Hernan Gomez. No good with the triple.
Trying to get his man back for the last three. It helps to not make this personal.
Passes to Melodon. Here's Baisley. Hernan Gomez covering. Shot clock at five. Here's Baisley again, Oklahoma City.
When the defense is non-existent like they were there, it's pretty easy to score like he did.
That's a good one. Good look.
Now Melton. He had a 12-point outing in their last game against the Raptors in Toronto.
And his defense was absolutely outstanding.
Oh, come on.
Two blocks, which helped turn the game.
And Glenn is a priority for them right now, but if this continues, it will be.
To the inside. That one's good, and the Grizzly lead has got down now to just four in the basket from Baisley.
We're coming back.
Scoreless first quarter. He's found a little rhythm here.
Here's Melton. Off to a good start as he hits his first shot attempt.
Man, I'll tell
that
you,
went
you
in.
Get your floater game going, it's a tremendous weapon.
Now a timeout called by Oklahoma City. This, of course, their first opportunity to play Memphis this season.
And this, the first of three games these two teams will play against one another this season.
On the bench.
And the Grizzlies.
Yep. Of course.
Now in the books.
Oh my gosh.
Live from the FedEx Forum. You're watching 2K Sports.
He's about 11. Hey, coach, that was stupid of you. Just saying.
And after a very lopsided first half, We'll see if things play out a little more evenly.
You better prove to me that was a good play on your part.
Now, he's checked in for Memphis. Bane comes in for Milton. And then for Oklahoma City, Baisley's checked in for Favors. Jack comes in for Roby. And MP subbed in for George. Here's Baisley.
Subbed in for who?
And the rejection.
Subbed in for who exactly?
Right now, they've got MP. And it's Baisley in at the center position. Here's Morant. Sinks that one from the post. Morant's got the lead up to 12 now for the Grizzlies.
With the ability to beat his defender in a number of ways, Morant is truly a dynamic scorer.
Giddy the pass to Gilgeous Alexander. Makes that one his sixth of the night. Very healthy, 6 for 9. And so many teams looking to space the floor. Greg, how many non-shooters can you play and still have a good offense?
Well, I think most teams go four out, meaning you got to have at least four guys that are a threat on the perimeter, keeping a vertical spacer at that dunker spot. But if your dunker can also shoot, man, that puts even more pressure on the defense.
Thunder trailing by 10. MP left side. It's deflected.
On the box shot, Dylan won't beat you with length, but he does have good lift off the floor.
All right, let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Alder.
Thank you, guys. We have seen today's athletes taking stands for social justice. All-star Bradley Beal says, "We understand there will be a backlash, but we don't care about that. I'm a human being, a citizen, just like everybody else. I have family and friends still living in those environments. I'm their voice." Kevin?
All right, David. Thank you very much. Greg, you know, you think back to when Gilgeous Alexander came to the Thunder, came over in that Paul George trade. He exploded after that deal.
And most of the focus on the picks the Thunder got, but Gilgeous Alexander has been the biggest return by far. Exploded once he arrived with the Thunder.
Baisley passes to MP. Morant with some nice D.
Frick.
And the Grizzlies leading by 8.
Can't make layups anymore either.
Brooks outside. Back to Morant. Over MP. Jackson down low.
God dang it. I thought you had to put the ball.
No good that time. And it's Oklahoma City the other way. They've got the Pistons ahead of them in their next game in Detroit. And that game will be game 2 of 3 straight on the road. Inside, here's Giddy. Good, and the assist goes to MP. Giddy's got 5 points now in the quarter. Timeout called, the Grizzlies.
Let's see if Coach can get them back on the right track.
Because right now, it feels like the pace is being dictated to them. They need to go back to playing their brand of basketball.
Substitution on the court.
Down by 5.
Second minute off the clock now in the fourth. Up at the forward spots, it's Anderson and Jackson. DeAnthony Melton out there with John Morant. And it's Adams in at the 5, roaming the paint. That's the lineup out there for the Grizzlies. And Morant's got the ball here for the Memphis Grizzlies. They held a 12-point lead early. Anderson outside.
Down by 3.
We're in the fourth quarter here.
Just
under 2.5 minutes
locked
gone.
In. Up.
Down to 5 on the shot clock. And again, Memphis no good.
He's tried to get it going, but the shots simply have not been there. Nothing seems to be falling.
MP right side. Back to Gilgeous Alexander. Here's Deck, guarded by Jackson. The shot. Gilgeous Alexander can't get it to go. And
dang
the foul it. Called on
MP. Why did I do that?
And Memphis making a change here. Brooks checked in.
Oh my God. I was close to free throws.
OB's checked in for Deck. Gilgeous Alexander against Morant. Brooks.
Come on.
Good. Nice assist from Morant. Brooks has got 5 points now in the quarter. Our a timeout called by Oklahoma City. They're trailing by six. 1:51 left in the fourth. And now, a moment to present the New Balance player of the game, Ja Morant.
And to me, the best part of his game has been the work he's done inside. I mean, slashing, driving the lane, attacking the basket at every chance. When he's had an opening, he's taken.
Offensive rebound, Favors. Got him with the pump fake, but couldn't finish. And the Grizzlies leading by six. Melton with the ball. Pass to Adams. Lays it up off the glass.
This is where Adams feasts. Get him the ball in his spots, and he does the rest.
The pass to Giddey. .112 left to play in the final quarter. To the paint, here's MP. The lead pass was put in just the right spot.
That's a well-timed, well-coordinated play. Comes right off the pick for the lay-in.
Morant outside. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line.
That's his first. How can you not love a player like Ja Morant? Came into the NBA ready to prove himself and just keeps getting better.
Second one is good. Bring both at the line. It's an 8-point game. 58 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Gilgeous Alexander against Adams. And terrific work on the offensive glass, and he picks up two.
The killer instinct of Favors. This man takes no prisoners when the game is on the line.
Here's Morant. And they pick up two. And the Grizzlies lead by eight.
They're in total command of this game with time starting to run out.
Reason why they've tightened up the vice grip a little more each time up the floor. We'll see if they can close this.
Why? I was open.
You could tell he thought that triple was going to fall.
Player can't freaking shoot.
Brooks against MP. Brooks misses. MP outside. He dishes it to Favors. Here's Giddey. And out of bounds as Memphis gains possession.
Didn't mean to run you over. Yeah, 2 seconds left if you put me out of the freaking game.
So it's Memphis picking up the win. They didn't make it easy for themselves. But in the end, everyone satisfied.
Well, I mean, there was just wrapping up for today's episode of NBA 2K22 My Career.
A lot of credit.
This was a mess.
In terms of finishing
so we won the first one, we lost the last two.
And that about wraps it up for Greg Anthony.
Like I said, this team's terrible. I want out of it. Okay, so. Yeah. So I will see you guys in the next episode. Hopefully we get out of this team as soon as possible.
Yo.
And
so
there's a cutscene.
I just got off the phone with your agents, and they want me to set up an interview with Candace Green. It's your turn to set the narrative.
Not gonna lie to you, man. I'm kind of nervous.
Well, as you should be. You're about to go on national television and complain about your boss. Now, I don't want you thinking that you're doing the wrong thing, because you're not. I mean, you got the right to work for whoever you want to work
for. Look, I hear you, Rick, but that's a lot of eyes on me, bro.
Yeah, that's why you make a lot of money. Facts.
Yeah, you're right. Candace Green, she is respectful. This ain't going to be no Frank Valentine situation.
Well, yeah. I mean, all you're doing is applying a little pressure. Respectfully.
You make that sound so easy. Respectfully.
Well, I'm sorry. Are we in the easy business? Because I could have sworn it was the NBA superstar / music and fashion mogul business, but I don't know.
All right. I got you. We got you, all right?
Look, just do your little manifestation visualization thing and just picture yourself killing it.
You're right. I got this. Yeah, it's cool. I got this.
Bet. So I'm going to call Candace, set up the meeting. I'll put it on your schedule.
Appreciate you, bro.
Anytime.
Okay, I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out, y'all.